All of this history is just kind of like everywhere. It's all around you, and that's really amazing. はじめまして、キアラ・ハーディングと申します。スタンフォード大学から参りました。国際関係に専攻しております。よろしくお願いいたします。
My name is Kiara Harding. I am a junior at Stanford University and I'm majoring in international relations. So I'm doing the fall semester for the Kyoto Consortium for Japanese Studies. And in the morning, I take intensive Japanese. And then in the afternoons, I take two classes. One is Kyoto Artisans and Their Worlds. And the other one is Japan and East Asia. In the Artisans course, every week we take a field trip to see a different artisan. Sometimes we see two or three. And every week is centered around a certain craft.So, like for example, last week we did metalwork, so we went to go see someone who makes traditional Japanese kettles, and then we also went to go see someone who makes traditional decorative metalwork, like decorative doorknobs and like the bells used for Buddhist rituals and the little end pieces for temples and shrines and stuff like that. So it's really cool. We get to see a lot of stuff that I think tourists don't get to see when they come to Kyoto. For the washi course, we went to a certain place that makes traditional wahon, Japanese books. And so the craftsmen there allowed us to make our own wahon and bring them home, which was really fun. And so I'm taking the Japan and East Asia course here, which focuses on international relations from the perspective of Japan. So we've been looking at a lot of, first of all, we started with some of the international relations basic concepts like realism and liberalism and stuff like that. And we're using that to focus on how Japan functions in the international space.So Japan's relationships with neighboring countries, how that's changed over time. And we really get into like a lot of interesting anecdotes that we get to analyze since we're here in Japan. We get to use that as a jumping off point for what we're studying. I think where KCGS fits into like my personal plans for my life and like for my career going forward is that, first of all, I've always wanted to study Japanese and come visit Japan. So it's fulfilled a dream that I've had up until now.But then also going forward, I want to be able to, first of all, get better in Japanese, and immersion is really the best way to do that, which has been really amazing being here. And then I'd also like to be a lawyer, but I'd like to work on international law or even maybe work in Tokyo someday. So I think that my KCGS experience will be really valuable for that. So right now I'm doing a homestay. I'm staying with a family of four, the mom, the dad, and two elementary school girls, and they're really sweet. They always like,teach me kanji I don't know or something. The fourth grader and I are probably about the same level in kanji, which is really funny. And we're always like joking around together and hanging out. Like this past weekend, we went to go make this thing called a shokuhin sampuru, which is like the plastic display foods that they have in stores. And they were really excited that we got to go make that together. So we always have a lot of fun. It's always like a really good atmosphere to be in. And I think I'm definitely learning a lot too, just from like living with a host family.For one of my community involvement projects, I got to join a taiko circle, a taiko club at a neighboring university. It was really interesting because I've always been interested in taiko, and I wanted to try it out. So they let me like, learn some of the basics. I got to practice with a lot of the first years, which was fun. And I got to see kind of how people use Japanese in everyday life, like people my age use it, which was a really informative experience for me as well. And it was really fun. I got to talk to some really interesting people too. Life in Kyoto is a really unique experience because it's such a historical city. Like I was in Tokyo for a little while before I came here, and that was kind of just like living in any major city. But when you come to Kyoto, you see like the temples and the shrines and like all of this history is just kind of like everywhere. It's all around you, and that's really amazing. And I think that it's something that you can really only experience here, because even though like Osaka is close by, so I've been to Osaka a couple of times, I've traveled to a couple other places in Japan as well, but like you don't get the same feeling of like history while you're living in the city that you do in Kyoto, and I think that's really special.